See if you can. I started out as a real estate investor, just little properties, little nice, inexpensive condos, one bedroom studio condos and apartments and lofts and things like that. And then from there, they went up in value because I bought good properties in good neighborhoods. I started to refinance them so I could pull some of the appreciation out and buy other properties. Then I started to increase the profitability by lease purchasing them. We'll talk a little bit about that today. It's still my favorite strategy. Lease purchase tenants are just better quality tenants. That evolved from the little condos and even some mobile homes to townhomes, and then eventually to houses, because on houses you make a lot more money if you're in the right markets and everything. And that'll eventually led to information business and information products. And those different cash flow streams fed the alligator. You guys know what I mean by alligator? I know my reg. What do I mean by alligator?
Rental properties.
Rental properties. We talked to, what was it, last week or 2 weeks ago? We talked about tenants from hell and how to control the tenants and what you should have in your contract and everything. You, these come through. We, you know, I try to share, shorten the learning curve for you guys. But basically, you're going to have a property eventually where you're going to have an eviction or you're going to have damage. And where's that money going to come from if you're just getting started? So the thing about it is, can you build up a war chest? Can you build up other streams of income? And when we say information, we mean coaching or consulting. Okay, I do that, and a few people in this room do that. I teach my students to do that, my licensees, to absolutely do that. That can be a six-figure per month income. And then the money from these other cash flow streams feed the alligator and also give you a war chest for purchasing other properties conventionally. There are some deals you can only purchase with 10 or 20% down and good credit in the bank. Sometimes you can get owner financing, but is cash king in a real estate business? You better believe it eventually. And you buy good properties in good neighborhoods. Guess what happens over 5, 10, 20 years? You know, you start out in your late 20s and then you grow up and you're older and your kids grow up and everything, and you still have a few key properties. Guess what those properties, you double up on your payments because you got more, you're taking in more cash than you need, and you double or triple up on your payments, and now you're mortgage free on your properties. And they keep appreciating. And maybe you get into specialty areas like land, like Brent does. I like land too. I've been doing a lot of land lately. No tenants in toilets anymore. Okay, I've been there, done that. So I just wanted to give you guys a ballpark.